to the chopper because the money is coming. Running through the hood in the middle of the summer, playing with the racks like it's a game of tennis. My
yes.
Damn man is in my damn
bed.
I've been working on the weekends. I can't talk to you no more. See me focused in my zone. I'm just trying to keep it simple. Why you focus on your mental? I can't play these games no more, no more. Now why you playing no
I'm
more?
I'm doing alright.
Welcome to the evening edition of the Closet Truth. I'm a good dude. Well, listen, thank you. That really does mean a lot. You know, a lot of people don't like what I do, okay? They say I'm a bad man. They say, Zeus, you've been very dangerous. You've been very mean to MAGA. And that's what we will continue to do. All right? So I've been getting inundated with a lot of misinformation coming from the Trump supporters. We had a conversation yesterday, ladies and gentlemen, and I went through great lengths to highlight all of President Biden's accomplishments, right? You know, I did all of that to illustrate the difference between a real president and a president that's a criminal. And I knew that when I did it, I knew the Trump supporters, they were going to lose it. They're out there screaming right now.
Help me!
Cut it out, clickbait. Cut it out, clickbait, before you end up in a straitjacket. I'm being serious. Biden's not a criminal. All right, so I'm getting inundated with this so-called breaking news. You know what the breaking news? Biden used a pseudonym, Robert L. Peters, when emailing his son's business associates, including using it to schedule secret calls with the president of Ukraine. You know what I gotta say? Take Trump supporters long to dig up more lies and conspiracies. Is it your full-time job, clickbait? Is this your full-time job to go around and dig up conspiracies about President Biden and his son? Right? The cult is restless. Right? So I looked at this letter, right? August 17th, 2023. And I kid you not, ladies and gentlemen, this letter, it had to have been written by a fifth grader. I don't even want to read it. It's so nasty, right? But in the letter, they're accusing President Biden of going by the alias Robert L. Peters. And I had to say to myself, I was in Snuggles Live, by the way. Snuggles was talking about this, right? Snuggles is laser-focused, Bach. I'm in Snuggles Live talking about this. And I said, now, wait a second. You mean to tell me President Biden is dementia. He has dementia. You mean to tell me that President Biden is Sleepy Joe? You mean to tell me that President Biden is, what do they call him? Very corrupt. He's a the big guy. They call him the big guy, right? So President Biden is also the big guy. And now today, on August 17th, right, which is today, President Biden's new name is Robert Peters. What a shame. What a shame. You have nothing on President Biden, clickbait. You really have nothing on President Biden. I wish these same hypocrites, these same Trump supporters, I wish they would spend this amount of time and effort that they got. You know, if you got all this free time to dig up conspiracies, I wish you would use this same time to do something else productive with your life, right? Hello, Velm. Nice to see you. I'm doing all right. Why can't you do something more productive with your life, right? Have you read? Clickbait. Have you read the indictment? Have you read any of these indictments, clickbait? I'm asking for a friend. Have you? All right. I'm being sincerely honest, because you brand yourself as more intelligent than Zeus, right? So if you're more intelligent than me, clickbait, you had to have read these indictments, right? Is he still out there? Okay, well then, you know what? I guess clickbait had enough. All right. Clickbait, answer the real questions, all right? Why do you wear the same? This is my TikTok uniform, clickbait. You don't see me in what I'm really in. If you did, you might be a little scared. You might feel insecure about yourself. I don't want to embarrass you now, clickbait. Is this your second account, clickbait? What happened to your first one? Clickbait. If you could at least get over 1,000 followers, you could get in the box and talk to me. I don't bite, right? Oh, ladies and gentlemen, we have a big spender, a big stepper in the audience. His name is Clickbait. Clickbait says he's rich. Does anyone out there believe Clickbait is as wealthy? Because we know Clickbait is a Trump supporter, and you know what Trump supporters love to do. They love to inflate everything, don't they? Everyone says no, so clickbait, I got some news for you, all right? In this live, in this kingdom, you're broke as a joke. Yeah. So clickbait, you're deflecting from the question. I asked you, in all of your brilliance and in all of your intelligence, hello, Shay, nice to see you. In all your brilliance and all of your intelligence, clickbait, have you read any of the indictments, all right? He's too dumb to be rich. Have you read any of the indictments, clickbait? I guess he hasn't, all right? So we're gonna abandon this nonsense that clickbait is talking about, ladies and gentlemen. And what I really want to do is make sure the Trump supporters understand this about President Biden. And I didn't want to do it. Oh, wait a second. Before I do, people ask me all the time, Zeus, why are you so mean to the Trump supporters? And I say, listen, it wasn't always this way between me and MAGA, but officially the gloves are now off, right? The gloves are off.
Everyone knows he's, and I wouldn't have said this 3 weeks ago. I wouldn't have said it. I was actually very kind to him. But now we can't be kind anymore because the gloves are off. The jar has been opened. He's taken millions of dollars from other countries like China. He's totally compromised. He's taken millions and millions of dollars from other countries.
Right. And you know the rules in here, everyone. Every MAGA accusation is truly a MAGA confession. Now listen up, click. You're in the comments right now. Now you want to fight Zeus. Look at this, ladies and gentlemen. Isn't this a shame? Oh! He wants to fight. Listen, clickbait, I just put a video up right now for people like you. Listen, you know how Donald Trump's being indicted in the state of Georgia, and you got all of his Trump supporters, they're doing nasty stuff all over the internet. They're threatening the jurors, right? They're threatening the jurors, they're threatening the judge. Clickbait, I got some breaking news for you. The FBI and the DOJ, they're monitoring all of you all across the internet, and they're setting the biggest trap you've ever known to ever see in the United States. Yeah, They're out here hunting for Trump supporters because they know, just like the rest of America know, you Trump supporters are deranged, right? They're deranged.
He's deranged.
Yeah, yeah. Well, no, yeah, clickbait is deranged, right?
He's deranged.
Oh, yeah. No, clickbait. Listen. You don't get to say what the FBI and the DOJ are doing. You don't trust those agencies, right? Don't sit back here. See, this is what we got going on right now, ladies and gentlemen. The Trump supporters are literally crying all over TikTok. I've never seen crying at this level. Hello, Spencer Cooper. Nice to see you. I go into their lives, and it's immediately, why, Zeus, why are the Democrats so angry? First of all, I'm not angry. I'm actually having the time of my life. Shay, are you having the time of your life? Greg, are you having the time of your life? Are there any Democrats in here right now that are enjoying Donald Trump getting indicted as much as I am? Any Democrats, by a show of hands, can you show me if you are having just as good of a time as I am about Donald J. Trump getting indicted? Paula, look at that. Nice lady. Yes, heaven, nice lady. So to the Trump supporters that are out there thinking that the Democrats are upset, we're not. Actually, I got off the phone with some real powerful Democrats, right? And they said, Zeus, keep doing the work you're doing, all right? The message is getting out there. Keep doing it. We got MAGA on the rails. The head of the dragon is about to be cut off by Fani Willis. All right? Fani Willis is cutting the head of the dragon. Jack Smith got the dragon weak and tired, right? The dragon was flailing around. Jack Smith put those shackles and brought it down to earth. But Fani Willis, she came in with the kiss of death and delivered the kiss of death to that MAGA-possessed dragon demon named Donald Trump. And you know what time it is, ladies and gentlemen? For those of you Trump supporters who don't know what Fani Willis said that ended Trump's career, I'm going to let you hear it once again. These choice words ended Donald Trump's dreams of becoming president. All right, MAGA, listen to it.
I am giving the defendants the opportunity to voluntarily surrender no later than noon on Friday, the 25th day of August, 2020.
Here I go.
Right?
You can hide.
Clickbait. That means it's over.
And take it slowly.
She gonna find Donald Trump.
Here I go.
And take it nice and slow.
Find you.
Yeah.
And make you one.
Go ahead.
Every individual charged in the indictment is charged with one count of violating Georgia's Racketeer Influenced and Corrupt Organizations Act today based on information developed by that investigation. A Fulton County grand jury returned a true bill of indictment. The indictment brings felony charges against
who?
Donald John Trump.
Who?
Rudolph William Lewis.
Who? Who? I didn't hear
John it. John Charles Eastman.
Who?
Mark Randall
Meadow.
John Chiro. Jeffrey Clark. Jenna Lynn Ellis.
Right, look at all these fines.
Ray Dolan Smith.
Look at all these crimes. Oh, God.
Robert David Chili.
Career's over.
Michael A. Roman. I am giving the defendants the opportunity to voluntarily surrender no later than noon on Friday, the 25th day of August, 2023.
Right there, clickbait. Right there, clickbait. That's what you call game over. Whatever plans you... Listen, I've never had anyone clear my calendar like that. Have any of you had anybody clear your calendar like that? This is supposed to be the front runner of the Republican Party, right? Have any of you had your calendar cleared like that? You know what Donald Trump had planned on the 25th? Oh, I'll tell you what he had planned. Oh, I didn't tell you that. I didn't tell you that. Oh, where are my manners? I'm so sorry. I should have told you. Oh. He was going to wake up, get a few rounds of golf in, send a few Truth Social posts. You know, that stuff he likes to say, you know. He was going to go off on Jack Smith.
Jack Smith. He's a Trump hater.
Yeah. He was going to say all of that. He was going to say all this Jack Smith stuff.
Deranged Jack Smith.
Right. He's going.
Donald Trump is indicted and they take one charge and they turn it into 36 charges.
He was going to do that on a Friday, you know, right before the weekend start. He was going to get on his cell phone, right? You know, he's going to get on his cell phone and, oh yeah, I'm going to light the world on fire. I'm going to send some hateful stuff to Jack Smith. I'm going to talk about Fani Willis. I'm going to talk about... And that was his plan. Until Fani Willis decided she had other more important things for Donald Trump. All right? That's how that works, you Trump supporters. You want to know what being a thug is like? You want to know what being a thug is like? I'll tell you. Watch Donald Trump. Fani Willis is treating your leader like a thug, all right? And she's giving him some thug passion, all right? You know what? I think I need to play it, right? Hey, let's play some thug passion for these Trump supporters because they don't know what a thug is. They don't know what a thug is, but we're going to show them what a thug is, right? Y'all want to hear a little thug passion? Y'all want a little thug passion? Let's see if we got a little thug passion. Let me see what I can find for you Trump supporter, all right?
All right, new drink. Mm-hmm. One part Alizé, one part Chris Stapp. Trump's fashion, baby.
This goes out to you, MAGA.
This drink is guaranteed to get the pussy wet and the dick hard. Oh. Now, if you with me, pour a glass and drink with me, you know what I mean? I ain't trying to turn y'all niggas into alcohols. I'll just try to turn you into motherfucking pills. So come get some of this thug fashion, baby.
Stop,
man.
I could put like they think. Till it's relevant, but I'm a straight soul.
Oh, yeah.
Like a citizen, tripping over dead presidents. They got the sterilists. I thought it was down with a spit. Trying to try to get it, and it's so rapid. And staying relevant. They drinking over a felony. Hell of me and that. It would be an hell of shit. People telling me, black, they ain't killing me.
He's a thug.
Cheese and a
please. Don't
rock it, plenty of cheese. I'm laughing from past two times. And all these bastards that be watching. Keep it playing, and I'ma keep it the same. Pilot to take it a simple game. I can linger with rain, twinkle, diamonds and things.
Go ahead.
Enough to hold me to.
Oh, this is that death row record.
They don't have to be worried, because I'ma be ill and fulfilling my passion till I'm buried in my dog
pen. And you got it going on. Give me some of your good passion.
Getting some thug passion from Miss Fani Willis. Friday, Donald Trump. You want to have a date, Donald Trump? You want to date me? All right, you can. Come on out here to this Fulton County, Rice County jail, my brother. All right? And then they get mad at me for telling the truth out here. And all I'm doing... Listen, clickbait, any of you Trump supporters... I'm not making any of this stuff up, all right? I'm not. I'm literally just sharing with you the same information that's available to everyone in the world. What's fascinating to me, I'll be honest with you, what's fascinating to me about all of this is that it scares you. It scares you. All of this stuff that we tell you, it scares you. And I know it scares you because I go into their lives, right? And when I go into their lives, the first thing they do, everybody, be quiet. Zeus is here. Oh, y'all get him. Everyone hide. This is what they do when I go into their life. Oh, and then in some cases, they'll block you. Oh, I can't have Zeus here. He's too honest, right? I know what Mike Pence felt like when he said Trump told him he was too honest. Because when I go into their lives, that's what they say. They say, Zeus, everything you say is scaring me. This is what they said. I am so scared right now, Zeus. I said, why are you scared? I'm in the comment section. Why are you scared? Because I just feel like The world is coming to the end. This is biblical, Zeus. This is wrong. I can't believe you are for the government. The government is destroying our country. This is what they tell me. And I've said, well, how is the government destroying our country? Well, don't you see Donald Trump? Don't you see Donald Trump is getting indicted all the time? It's like all this hate against one man, Zeus. Don't you feel like the world is coming to an end? And I said, well, wait a second. Remember, Donald Trump said every time he gets indicted, it's a great badge of courage.
Every time the radical left Democrats, Marxists, communists, and fascists indict me, I consider it a great badge of courage.
Right. And when I heard Donald Trump say that, I said, well, that's it. That's it right there. He considers the Department of Justice and the FBI and Fani Willis indicting him a good thing. It's a good thing. So why are all of you so afraid to see him in handcuffs? Right? There's nothing scary about Donald Trump being in handcuffs. Trust me, he's been in handcuffs before, just not like this. But this is nothing. Listen, if he was scared of handcuffs, he wouldn't have broke the law, right? He wouldn't have broke the law if he was scared of handcuffs, all right? He wouldn't have attacked those black women out there counting votes. And by the way, why did he attack those black women? Did he think that they wouldn't stand up to him, huh? Why did he attack those black women? Why is he attacking Fani Willis, huh? Why is he calling her racist? Huh? You ever thought about that, Trump supporters? And then he gets on his platform, Truth Social. He gets on his platform, Truth Social, and he cries, it's the DOJ. And I said, now listen up, Trump. Didn't you just say it's a great badge of courage? Yeah? Well, stop crying. Stop crying and deal with it. Be a man, Donald Trump. Be a man. Yeah, they don't like me because I tell MAGA the truth. I don't sugarcoat the truth with MAGA anymore, folks, because they always say they're the smartest ones in the room. So if you're that smart, I don't need to sugarcoat it, right? And if you think I'm making this stuff up, you could go look it up yourself. Don't come in here with this Robert Peters nonsense telling me that President Biden has a new alias. How many aliases does President Biden have? Seriously. Is he Sleepy Joe? Is he dementia? He can't stand? Which one is it? His son's a crackhead? I mean, how is he doing all this stuff and still beating Donald Trump? Think about that, MAGA. What MAGA? Listen, I've never been this happy in my life to see law enforcement working, right? And you know that's a big statement coming from me because, you know, I'm a brother out here in the real world, right? That's a big statement for me to sit back and be going like this when I see police officers. It's a 180, if you ask me. So for me to be clapping for police officers, you know, this is something unprecedented. I'm being real honest with you. To back the blue like I back the blue now. Yes, put them all in jail. Yes, all 1,000 plus of those individuals who attacked our Capitol on January 6th, please put them in jail, because the jail might be the best stop. That might be the one thing that stopped them from going to hell, right? Listen, there's no Biden crime family. I already debunked it. Are you just new to the program? I've already debunked it. There's no Biden crime family. Listen up, Trump supporters. You're going to get very far in life if you simply acknowledge there's no Biden crime family. But I'll tell you what, there's a Trump crime family, and we got proof. We got proof because the ringleader of the Trump crime family, Donald Trump, is currently hovering at 91 indictments, right? He got 91 felonies, I'm sorry. 91 felonies. With more on the way, because I hear in the state of Georgia, Arizona, I hear they're also looking to bring charges against Donald Trump. Listen, it's like that song Michael Jackson used to sing, Don't Stop Till You Get Enough. Yeah, DOJ. Listen, any DAs out here in the United States, any of you DAs in any of those seven states where Trump was trying to steal votes, you know what I look at stealing votes like? I really do look at it as printing counterfeit money, right? So you're on that level with what Trump did. Any DAs out there, if you are listening to what I'm saying, please do America a huge favor and waste not another day indicting Donald Trump and all of his co-conspirators. Let's put they behinds in jail. Because if we get them in jail, we just might be able to save their soul and save them from going to hell, right? And listen, you got all these Trump supporters. They call your names out here. Listen, anybody who's been called a name by a Trump supporter, I just got something to say to you. Count it all joy. Count it all joy when they call you a name. Because I would rather be whatever they call me than to be one of them. Ain't that right? You can call me whatever you want, but I don't call me a Trump supporter. Them is fighting words, right? I see, listen, I already know, like many of you know, if anyone calls you MAGA, you ain't nothing but one or two steps away from being a prisoner for Donald Trump. And under no certain conditions will I ever be a prisoner for Donald Trump. Absolutely not. Like I said before, I enjoy my freedoms. I love getting in my car. I love driving where I want to drive. I love going and buying clothes that I like. I like going. I like stainless steel appliances and TV. I love all that stuff. There's no way I will share a jail cell with another grown man on behalf of Donald Trump. You can kiss that deal goodbye. And you got folks, what's his name? Corn Pop. There's a guy named Corn Pop going on out here. He's rallying up all the Trump supporters. You should call this number and get Stacey Abrams put in jail. And I said, well, listen, first of all, so now you believe in justice, right? Yeah, I believe in justice only when it applies to Stacey Abrams. Okay, and so you're going to give your Trump supporter and friends this phone number to call and harass this woman. Yes, Zeus, that's what we got to do. And I said, you sure you want to do that? Yeah, I want to do it. Okay. What did the article come out today and say? Oh, the DOJ and various agencies are one by one arresting all of Trump supporters who've been online making threats. Huh? What gets me about all of this online stuff, it's almost like Trump supporters don't know how technology works. Everything you do online is being recorded. Not by Democrats, okay? By the companies, okay? And if you break those guidelines that the companies put in place, they are bound by law to report it, especially if it's criminal. So these Trump supporters don't even realize that when they get to court, there's not going to be, well, I'm going to go in and I'm going to defend myself because they don't know who Corn Pop is or whatever he calls Cornball. They don't know who Snuggles is. They don't know who I am because I changed my name. You sound as ridiculous as these same folks who said they was trying to delete the server at Mar-a-Lago. I was trying to delete the server, Jax. I was trying to delete the server, Jack Smith. And they talking to the DOJ right now. How did you find me, Jack Smith? You knuckleheads. Y'all don't know how this technology works. All right, I got to open up the box before I get out of this closet of truth. All right, ladies and gentlemen. What an interesting day, right? All right, what an interesting day. It's time to hear from those of you who are brave enough to get in the box. I think I was thinking about how to say how do I do what I do. There's only really one rule. How do you say that thing? There's only one rule I have. Nobody is allowed to get into my box and lie. I don't care what side of the aisle you're on. If you get in the box and you start lying, I'm going to ask you to... Oh, yes, and keep it clean. Yeah, no cursing and none of that profanity and name-calling. If you got that MAGA-possessed demon in you still, the only... Okay, if you are a Trump supporter, I'll make an exception. If you are a Trump supporter, I will make an exception, all right? And the exception is this. You have to be willing to get in the box today and apologize. Any Trump supporters out there want to apologize today by show of hands? Any Trump supporters out there want to apologize by show of hands? Oh, okay. You don't know why I'm asking you to apologize. All right. I forgot to say that. Where are my manners? I always leave a space in my life open for a Trump supporter to get in the box and apologize to the United States of America. All right? Because what you did to our country for 4 years, especially on January 6th, you know what? I'm blaming COVID on the Trump supporters now. What you Trump supporters did with the pandemic, what you Trump supporters did on January 6th, what you Trump supporters did with those classified documents, what you Trump supporters did up there in the state of New York with Stormy Daniels, all of those abusive things you've done to this country, you've drug our nation through all of this hell on behalf of one man. All right. And we're still dealing with it, by the way. That's why you owe an apology to the United States. So any Trump supporters want to apologize today by a show of hands? I'm glad you asked me why. Any Trump supporters? I'm not being funny. No, this is serious. Oh, yeah, it's definitely treason. And you got to apologize for your racism. Yeah, that's a good one. Time to repent and apologize, you MAGA-possessed demon hypocrites. All right. And listen, I'm going to get to the box. But if you're in this live, Trump supporters, listen to me. If you are in this live right now, and the words that I'm saying to you is making you feel uncomfortable, it's making you feel angry, you're sitting at home right now, you just got done eating a Big Mac, all right, supersized with a Coke, and you're in your feelings right now, this live is making you upset, you're looking at me, I'm looking at you, right, I'm looking at you, and you're angry, do me a huge favor. Just leave. You can leave this live. Just swipe up and go on about your life, all right? Don't worry, the DOJ and the FBI, they recorded everything you put in the comment section. You'll be fine, all right? But you don't gotta take my word for it. Listen to your leader.
If you're not happy here, then you can leave. As far as I'm concerned, if you hate our country, if you're not happy here, you can leave. If you're not happy in the U.S., if you're complaining all the time,
yeah,
very simply, you can leave. You can leave right now. Come back if you want. Don't come back. It's okay too. But if you're not happy, you can leave.
Right. And that's one of the few times I agree with Donald Trump. Because, and I've been asking this question for a while right now. You don't have to be here in the United States, MAGA. You don't. You can leave. There's no one here forcing you to stay here. And I've asked a lot of people. By the way, let me ask again. Is there anyone here that's holding a Trump supporter hostage and forcing them to stay in the United States by a show of hands? Is there anyone out there forcing MAGA to stay? Why? Is there anyone out there forcing MAGA to stay by a show of hands? I'm asking. No? No? You see that, MAGA? You can leave. You really can. You can go to Russia with Vladimir Putin. You can go to China with Kim Jong-un. I mean, that's North Korea. You can go to China with President Xi. But there's not one American in this live that's forcing you to stay here. Just leave. And I mean that with my whole chest. You don't need to commit crimes. You don't need to tell us. You don't need to do that thing, you know, when people break up. If I don't get my way, I'm leaving. Don't even threaten to leave. Just pack your bags. Go. Okay? We'll be fine. I promise you. I promise you. Don't go online and threaten anybody else. Just, it's over. Because as far as I'm concerned, Fani Willis has Fani Willis has ended MAGA. Jack Smith has ended MAGA. And we, the people, have officially ended MAGA. There will never, ever be a Trump 2024. Unless you're talking about 20 to 24 years in jail. And I mean that with my whole chest, all right? I'm going to open up the box. It's time to hear from other people, all right? They don't like me because I tell the truth, but you know what? And you.
Okay.
Oh, I'm all right. Just another day in the closet of truth.
Yeah, you know, so it's very interesting. I was in our friend Snuggles Live earlier today. Mm. First of all, amazing that you played Tupac in here. I mean, way to represent, you know, the brand and everything that it is about, you right. know, West Side, Thug Life,
right.
you know, all that good stuff.
Right.
And so I was in that live today, and Mr. Snuggles was extremely excited about his live. He was playing Welcome to the Jungle, right? He was playing Welcome to the Jungle. And he was getting fired up. It was like he was about to go out on the football field and play. And he gets 4 minutes into his live showing a video that's been debunked like probably 15 to 20 times. Right. And then his live just got shut down.
That's what happens when you're on TikTok spreading lies and misinformation.
And that's not us. And that's not us. That's no. TikTok. Remember, that's TikTok not appreciating what you're doing. Spreading these lies and disinformation. It's mm-hmm. just what it is, man.
Mm-hmm.
Own up to it. And the other thing is that, you know, we've got a lot of people still who are very angry about a lot of things. We got a lot of people angry about the $700 that is being sent to Hawaii.
Are they still talking about that $700? Listen, now I'm a little more upset again. See, I was going to be kinder, but now the gloves are off, right?
Gloves are off.
How much money have these same hypocrites sent those people out there in Hawaii? Have they sent any money?
Well, they've sent their mortgage to Donald Trump, so they don't have a lot of money left.
Okay, but this is what I'm talking about. Now, all of a sudden, you know, this is the thing about Trump supporters right now. Now that Donald Trump is going to jail, they somehow figured out a way to try to portray themselves as victims. Isn't this so funny? Now they care about Hawaii.
Yeah, right? They care about Hawaii, and they didn't care about Puerto Rico. You know, I heard earlier today, you know, Donald Trump went down there with a blank check, and he helped everybody. He didn't do that. The way it works is, you have to go through Congress for the FEMA aid, and Congress is on a recess right now.
Right.
So why are you not calling your Congress members who are Republican and they lead and they're the House majority? Why aren't you calling them and telling them to come back and vote on the
Because they're spending all their time coming up with more conspiracies about President Biden and Hunter Biden. These Trump supporters haven't sent a dime to these folks out there in Hawaii. And last time they came up with a thing, you know, remember East Palestine in Ohio when the train?
Right.
What did we find out just last week? Marjorie Taylor Greene's campaign manager was running a scam up there, taking money from the children.
And these guys, they're mad about, you know, Palestine, Ohio, and the fact that, like, you know, it was such a bad response. Well, first of all, the governor of Ohio didn't even want that money.
Right.
And then the mayor of the city said, oh, we don't want you here. So Joe Biden goes to the state and is seen with a guy who doesn't like him. He's now a part of all these political ads that are going to be on television showing that Joe Biden, it's like the opposite of a photo op. Donald Trump went down to Puerto Rico to throw paper towels for a photo op. And so if you send him to Ohio or Hawaii, there's really no purpose of him being there other than Republicans yelling at him and putting him in a advertisement or a campaign ad, trying to blame it all on him.
Right.
So that, but if you know, I read off in Snuggles Live earlier today what they are doing in Hawaii right now. They've already got FEMA working over there. They got people on the ground. They're supplying blankets. They've got military members down there. This is not. It's not like there's nothing happening. What we're waiting on is we need Congress to appropriate that money.
Yeah.
And because Congress has decided that they don't want to do that, well, we're not going to be able to do that. And, you know, so again.
And this is why it's important. And I'm glad that you're getting this out here, ZPAC, because if you leave it up to these MAGA possessed people, they will have you believing that Biden isn't doing anything. They actually were, you know, I was in Snuggles Live, and they're trying to say it was a laser that started this aura.
Yeah, they believe that a laser started the fire. They believe that aliens are real. They believe, well, that could be true. But they believe that the trees didn't catch on fire because the trees somehow, it's amazing what these people are doing.
And 99% of Trump supporters, this is based off of a statistic I've looked, I don't know quite yet, but I think it's around here. 99% of Trump supporters have never left the town they grew up in. What a shame.
Yeah, I mean, and so.
And don't blame me. I'm telling you the truth. They've never left the town.
Yeah.
So how do they know what's going on outside of the town they grew up in?
Well, because they watch a TikTok video and then they assume it's true. You know, they think that, you know, a TikTok video of a tree not burned proves that a laser or a lightning bolt. I mean, these folks have never heard of Occam's razor. Like, they're literally out here and everything's a conspiracy theory. Everything's a problem. Meanwhile, these are the same people that won't even that really don't want the government involved in anything, but when it comes to a disaster, it's like, oh, all of a sudden we want the government.
Now they're victims, right? Now when there's a disaster and it's usually self-inflicted, these same people that hate President Biden every single day turn around and their hands, they beg so much they look like cups, right? And they had their hands out to President Biden. If I was Biden, I'd slap their hand away from me. Get your begging hands away from me.
And also, they said that
he can't do that. He's the president, right? But if I was Biden, that's what I would.
The water, they said, was electric, or they said it couldn't be electric. But the problem is the electricity is what makes the water pump work. So they were talking about something about electricity, how the electricity was shut off or something like that. But in the water, because of a TikTok, I don't even know what it was about, because it was so outlandish and out there that I don't even know. And I don't want to even get in trouble for saying it, because I might, you know, get in trouble, you know.
Thank you. Well, I'll say this. This is why I don't take MAGA seriously. You mean to tell me these geniuses, you know, these experts that they call themselves, these TikTok lawyers, these fake TikTok hosts, they can tell you how to solve a natural disaster that took place in Hawaii. They can tell you how to do everything it can to fix that. But they can't explain why Donald Trump's been indicted 4 times.
Right. I mean, they're so backwards. They have no information. They have no...
I refuse to listen to them.
They just have nothing. I mean, they're backed into a wall. They have to get on this app. They have to, you know, complain about everything. If you're complaining all the time, like your recording says, you can leave. Just get out of here. If you're complaining all the time. And you should see, I mean, you were there, but I mean, it goes beyond, you know, they say, don't make it political, right? Don't make this a political issue. Well, you're the ones that make it political. You're the ones that are doing it. Yeah. There's nobody else making it political. We're saying what Joe Biden has done is asked for $200 more than he normally get, than you normally get, right?
Right.
And so what he did was he went out and he gave it to him. And he's got FEMA there. They're already working on the ground. He's got agents. He's got, you know, they're supplying rescue efforts and things like that. They act like there's nothing going on over there. And there
is. That's why I say President Biden, he's a great president because he's better than me. I would be like, oh, these folks, they out here saying this stuff about me? Absolutely not. But he takes his job as president very serious. You know, he's America's president. And that even goes to the MAGA. All right.
Yeah,
he's really your president, and he puts his own personal ego aside, and he delivers, hands down.
Yeah, he delivers. He delivers the goods, and he's got it. He's got it going. And
okay,
unfortunately, these MAGA folks, they're still riding this train till the wheels fall off. I guess that's all.
Well, listen, Brother Greg, I got to bring up some more people, but as always, it's a pleasure checking in with you and making sure we do our part to get this truth out here to those who care, all right?
And Zeus, you're the man. Tupac for life, you know?
Thug life.
Love it. Thug life.
All right. Are you still doing Tupac Tuesdays?
I did it this week, yeah. I did it last week, but, you know, I feel like I've gotten more than... more traction with political stuff than I have Tupac stuff, so whatever.
Yeah,
it's all good.
It's all good, though. Keep up the good work, my man.
All right.
All right. Yeah. Gentlemen, let's give you back a round of applause. And I saw a comment, and I really do believe it was a genuine comment. They said, Zeus, what about the people there that are local? I want to remind people that in the United States of America, you know, you often think that the government can do whatever it wants, but it really can't. The government, the federal government is different than the state government, and the state government is different than the local government. Because what ends up happening in a lot of cases, when one of those governments oversteps their boundaries and gets into territory they shouldn't be in, lawsuits happen. You get people who suffer in the middle of the, you know, the confusion. And so a lot of this stuff, there really should be policies and procedures already in place to address how each government responds. What this is an exercise of is making sure all of your local officials are doing everything they can to make sure they can provide relief to you, the people. I'm being honest with you. It's very difficult to ask the President of the United States to insert himself in local issues. Okay, usually there's a lot of red tape in that, all right? So when you hear these people out here and they say Biden should be here, you got to keep in mind that Biden can't come to your city and tell your mayor or your governor what to do on day one. He would be getting sued out of his you know what. It doesn't work like that, all right? That's just how it works. If you don't like it, you know what I always say, you can get involved in local politics. You can get involved in state politics. You can get involved in national politics and implement change as you see fit. That's how this works. All right. This is not one of those countries where we have a dictator. All right. So when you hear these Trump supporters that are crying about Biden isn't there, you got to think to yourself, these are the same people that can't explain why the person they voted for is currently being indicted in four different venues. They think it's a conspiracy. No, it's not a conspiracy. It's breaking the law. All right. And if you don't believe me, do this exercise. Go to any prison, go to any jail. Listen, go to any prison, any jail, and just talk to somebody who's doing time in there and go in there and ask, are you innocent? And most of the time, you know what they'll say? They'll say, yes, I'm innocent. I got a bad attorney. The judge had it out for me. Man, it was all... Listen, everybody in jail thinks they're innocent. I'm just being honest, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Oh, my goodness. I got to bring up our next guest. Who do we have here? Good afternoon, Donette. Greetings. How are you? Donette, are you there? Hello, are you there? Well, going once, going twice, gone. Donette, he can send another request, but I gotta move it on. Fetty said, greetings, welcome to the kingdom. Fetty said, greetings.
Hey, what's up? You're the first one to say it right. Correct. All right. Just wanted to say, man, you know, you said that they can leave, but where are they going to go?
This is our first time doing business. You know what I got to do?
Yes, it is.
All right. So I got to ask you some questions.
All right.
Right ahead. That matter to those of us in the kingdom. A lot of the viewers here, they get on me if I don't do this to people we've never talked to. All right.
No worries.
All right.
Good to meet you, my brother.
All right, so you promise to be honest, as honest as you can, right?
Yes.
All right, because a lot of people don't get honest in the box because they're worried their viewers might hear them say something, you know, and they don't want to get caught saying things that they don't normally say in front of their real friends. So I'm just giving you a heads up, but I'm going to ask the questions. First question.
Go ahead.
In your opinion, was the 2020 election stolen by this guy, President Joe Biden?
Absolutely not.
Hey!
No way it was, you know, and I remember a time
we got two more questions.
Oh, go right ahead. Go right ahead. Okay. I was gonna expound on that one, but go right ahead.
Well, you can after. I just want to make sure.
Okay, no worries.
Next question. In your opinion, who would you say is responsible for the attack on our Capitol on January 6th?
DJT.
Hey!
Donald John Trump.
All right, last and final question, and this is going to come at you like a curveball. Is President Biden or Hillary Clinton guilty of any crimes?
No, sir. Allegations are just that. You got to have the evidence.
All right, I gotta give you a follow, Fetty.
All right.
All right, what brings you to the closet of truth, my brother?
Well, to be honest with you, man, you know, you would have to be an abject idiot to think that there is a conspiracy with all these different states after one man.
Right.
And all you have to do is see, think about it. Donald Trump would have just let, you know, just got out of office and said, you know what, it's over with. Let me go play golf at Mar-a-Lago, whatever, and right, not said a word. Those people wouldn't have gone down there and assaulted the Capitol. I had people down here in Florida, man. I'll tell you, it was crazy. I get somebody in my car, and I'm an Uber driver, right?
Mm-hmm.
And she says, yeah, one of my clients is going to go to the Capitol. And I said, for what? This is December of 2020. And she said, well, it's going to be great. I said, why are they going down there?
Wow.
They're going to stop the steal. And I said, if I were you, I would tell your client not to go down there.
Right.
Because they will be arrested, right?
Right.
8 months later, they went down there. That same couple in Dunellen, Florida, were arrested. Absolutely. Went to the house and took him out there. Dog walked him to the car. Same. And she said, I couldn't believe it. I said, well, I told you.
Yeah.
I said, you can't do that.
Listen, every Trump supporter should know jail is a requirement.
Exactly. Exactly.
Right? They always get shot when they end up in jail.
Exactly, exactly. And then, you know, the fact that you said they should go out of the country, they should leave.
Yeah.
The only problem with that is, if they go to China, which I've been to China, you can't take your Bible with you. You go to China with a Bible, they'll put you in jail. You don't have the freedoms that you have in this country.
Oh.
Believe that.
But listen, Seti, they think that they're being mistreated in this country.
I've been all around the world, my man. I'm going to tell you something. This is the greatest country in the world. With all our problems, we still have a great country.
Mm.
And you have freedoms to go anywhere you want to.
Mm.
You can't do that in China.
Mm.
If you get a job in China and you want to change jobs, then you don't have a job. Because you can't just change jobs. You can't do it.
Listen, are you sure you want to tell these Trump supporters that? They don't think that's how it works over there.
No, man. I'm telling you.
They
it is.
President Xi and Kim Jong-un and Vladimir Putin, they think of them as heroes.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. When you're inside a Chinese prison and you can't contact anybody, you have no rights at all, no one's going to come and get you. You can believe that. Absolutely not.
Wait a second. You're telling me if a Trump supporter is in a Chinese prison, Donald Trump won't come and help him?
I don't think so.
Oh.
Absolutely not. Why not tell you what? And then if you go to Russia, same thing.
Oh.
Do you think, let me ask you a question. Do you think the people in Russia can own guns?
No.
So all this Second Amendment stuff, you can't take your guns with you? You better stay in the United States. Absolutely.
Listen, Steady. I'm trying to encourage them to go. All right? Because I did a poll, right? I said, is there anybody here forcing MAGA to stay? And everybody says no, right? So if no one's forcing them to stay here, don't you think it makes sense for someone that's in a bad, nasty relationship, right? Imagine you're in a bad relationship and you don't like it. Does it make sense to stay?
Go.
Yeah.
See ya. Absolutely. Doesn't make any sense at all. I mean, you know, if you want to, if you think you'll be happier in another country, go right ahead.
Yeah.
You know, it's just, it's crazy.
Yeah. We
absolutely.
I mean, we can, you probably will stop a lot of these fossil fuels from being burned here. You'll probably save a lot of people money on their heat utility bills, right? We'll probably have less traffic on the roads. Why stay in a relationship that's toxic?
I went to Germany last year, about a year and a half ago, right? And I was gonna rent a car to drive on the Autobahn, right?
Mm-hmm.
Drive by a petrol station, and the petrol, the gas, was 1.87. Euros per liter.
What?
They're over here crying about gas. It was like $10-$12 a gallon. So what do? We went ahead and just rode the trains and the buses, my man.
You said you went on the train and the buses. It wasn't
exactly. And I'll tell you what. And they run on time, my brother. They're unbelievable.
You didn't protest?
Absolutely not.
What? Why not? You didn't say, I'm an American, and those prices are outrageous.
Wait, that train's going 200 miles an hour, dude. I'm going from Berlin to Munich, or Munich to Berlin, in 3 hours when it would take you 6 hours in a car. I'm going to ride the train. Absolutely.
Yeah, that's why I tell a lot of these Trump supporters, you better sit your special behind them.
Exactly. All right?
And listen to this special broadcast. Well, it sounds like you're out and about having a great time in the kingdom, my brother.
No, brother. It's really nice talking to you. It's my first time with you, my man. You do a really good job. You ought to do a little bit more of your raps, man, because I think you're pretty good at that, man.
All right. Well, thank you, my
brother. I'm not really big on rap. I like the 90s rap and the 80s and 70s. I'm a little older than you guys. Okay. And the stuff they got coming out now, man, I just can't relate to. But yeah. you give me Biggie and Tupac, I'm right there.
All right. Yeah, that's right in your pocket, huh?
Exactly. Man, it's real nice talking to you, man. Have a good one, and I'll hit you up next week.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give Brother City Sid a round of applause. No lies detected. This is what we do, ladies and gentlemen. It's very important that we get this truth out here so that people, when they go and vote, they don't end up making a silly decision like they did when they voted for Donald Trump in 2016 and 2020. All right. I'm looking at the comments, and I'm going to ask again. Are there any Trump supporters that want to apologize today? Any Trump supporter, by a show of hands, raise your hand if you are a Trump supporter and you're willing to denounce Donald Trump today and apologize to the United States. All right? No? No? I guess I gotta continue the wonderful work that I've been doing, right? It sounds funny, but I'm serious. My box is always open on this platform for any MAGA that wants to get in the box. Hello, Tiffany, nice to see you. And apologize for being traitors. All right. And don't act like you're upset. Don't act like you're all of a sudden America's newest victims. All right, Trump supporters, because we've caught your hand in the cookie jar on so many occasions. At this point, you're worse than the Cookie Monster. January 6th was a Pelosi hoax. You see this, ladies and gentlemen, that's what you call a MAGA-possessed demon right there. They still, like I said, these same folks are outraged about what's happening in Hawaii, but they can't explain why Donald Trump keeps getting indicted. Have you read any of the indictments? Have you read it? Where's clickbait at? I mean, somebody, somebody go find me the most smartest, intelligent MAGA person on this platform. Can someone please summon them? Because I'm done talking to the little fish, right? I'm tired of talking to the little fish. I just want to talk to one Trump supporter that has really read the indictment, and it just seems like they don't exist. I might as well be asking for Big Bird, right? I might as well be asking for Big Bird. All right. Let's bring up our next guest. Good afternoon, Hazel.
Hi, darling. How are you?
I'm doing just fine. How are you?
Good. So most people, it's called the sunk cost fallacy. Have you heard of this?
What is it?
The sunk cost fallacy.
The sunk cost fallacy.
Yes. Basically, you have invested so much time and so much energy into something that you won't let it go. It's why people stay in toxic relationships. It's why these people, these Trumpers, they've invested all of their effort and all of their time and all of their support into this man that they can't possibly walk away. It allows them to add up values and ranges to something that just really isn't there.
Mm.
They make irrational decisions to lead to a suboptimal outcome, basically.
Mm. So they don't have an identity without Trump.
Exactly. I have TDS. Oh, okay.
That's, don't listen to when they get out here and they start, you know, that's that MAGA demon.
Oh, you know me, I don't care.
Yeah. The MAGA demon makes them say stuff, nasty stuff they wouldn't normally say to anybody. They say it out here on TikTok to people.
Most people wouldn't say half the shit that they say to my face.
Oh, yeah, you gotta keep it clean, Hazel.
Oh, I'm sorry. Most people wouldn't say half the things that they say to my face. Yes, I am a breakup artist. Your point?
Yeah. Yeah.
I am.
Yeah, and she's doing
I break up with dirty ideas such as Trump. Well, I didn't have that idea, but the idea that dirty things shouldn't be stayed with.
Yeah.
And most people should do that. You know, take a reevaluation of where your beliefs are and where you're standing and where you are in life. You should do that period, you know, every 4 to 5 years. Take a self-evaluation, take a look in the mirror and see what you're doing.
Yeah.
Because if it doesn't really line up with what you want, what the hell are you doing? Is Trump really what you want? Or is that just somebody that you cannot let go of because you've supported him for so long, and now you're going to look, what, dumb if you left? No, the rest of the world's going to look at you like you're smart.
Hey, people welcome you. I love it.
And you can stay a Republican. Do it. I mean, it's gross, but do it. Go ahead. It's fine.
Yeah.
But just get away from Trump.
Yeah.
That's all.
You hear that, Trump supporters? Tell them, Hazel.
Go reevaluate. Go see a therapist. Go talk to a psychiatrist so that they can talk to you about the sunk cost fallacy and why that's not optimal for you.
Yeah.
Because what has he really done? And don't get me wrong. Please don't anybody in the comments call me a Biden fan, because I'm not a Biden fan either. But we all have to kind of agree that Trump is not good for any of us.
Right.
Certainly not good for the majority of the nation trying to make some money.
You hear this, Trump supporters? Tell them, Hazel.
Let it go. Let it go.
What do you think he did to attract all of these people to him?
He gave them a platform in order to say what's on your mind. It's okay. He's just saying what we all thinking.
Mm.
But he wasn't saying what we are all thinking. He was saying what a small, well, unfortunately, half the population apparently was thinking.
Wow.
Being that half of them voted for him, and that's so disgusting. But, you know, even a lot of people that voted for him, I'll say this, I don't dislike all of them. There's a couple that I wish weren't Trump supporters, but I also understand these are people that are very narrow-minded. They don't quite look at the big picture. They're looking at only their picture. What's going to be this piece of art I'm trying to draw here?
Yeah. Would you say they're on the selfish side of things?
Absolutely.
Wow.
And there are people that I absolutely adore that are very selfish. They're not even Trump supporters that are very selfish.
Yeah.
They will not look beyond their front yard to see what's going on.
This is hitting real close to home. And I know there's a lot of MAGA folks out there listening to what you're saying.
It's upsetting.
Yeah, they're getting upset with it, but please continue, because somebody needs to tell them.
It's like if I call you and say, hey, this guy just broke in my house and punched me in the face.
Mm.
And you say, oh, yeah, he just came over for coffee. I'm hanging out with him. What?
Wow.
Why are you doing that? You know that he just did this. We're really good friends. Why are you doing that? Can you at least talk to him? Nah, right. That's none of my business.
Oh.
Do you know what I'm saying? It's like it's that kind of thing.
Hmm. They think it's okay for Trump to be abusive.
As long as it's not them.
Oh! This explains everything.
That's a lot of how people act.
Mm.
I've seen it on here just with friends. Mm. Oh, well, that person didn't do anything to me, so it's fine. Mm. But on a larger scale, it's the same thing with Trump. Trump is doing a lot. But the messed up thing with Trump is that not only has Trump done something to me, this person that punched me in the face and stole all my stuff, he went over to your house, but to your face is your friend, and did that stuff, but you didn't know it. So you're letting this person abuse you, and you don't even realize it, because you're just like, oh no, he would never do that. Mm. He's just behind your back doing
it. No lies detected, correct. Yeah.
And a lot of most people don't want to go against the herd.
Oh, so they got a herd mentality.
So much so.
Mm. This is scary, but and alarming at the same time. Is there any hope for them, Hazel?
Yeah. It is so easy to change. You know what you gotta do?
What?
I don't want to be a dick. Excuse my language. I know you don't like that, but that's basically what it is. I don't want to be this person. So change.
Mm.
It's not an addiction.
Mm.
You feel me? You can be a good person. You can say tomorrow, oh, I'm going to be a good person. And each day, I'm going to be a better person than I was yesterday.
Mm.
I'm going to think about others. I'm going to do something for somebody else that I don't even know.
Mm.
Try that.
Mm. Yeah, sounds like you're telling them to grow up.
Someone that's not even in my neighborhood. I'm going to go to another neighborhood and just do something for somebody just because.
Mm. Get out and start volunteering, Trump supporters.
There you go.
Amen.
And you don't even have to do that. Go to your local cashier and just give her an extra $20 because she's probably struggling. Or he, depending on who it is. I always have a she that I go through her line all the time.
Yeah.
I'm a creature of habit. But I mean, there's just these little things that people can do and they just won't. Mm. And if you ask them, like, well, I had somebody recently tell me that, what was the point? So why do you always volunteer? Why are you always doing stuff for your community? Why are you always doing this or that? Why not? I was put on this earth with a purpose. My purpose happens to be making the world better. And
Amen.
I think that's everyone's purpose.
Hey,
what are you doing if you're not trying to make the world better, if you're not trying to repair it in some way?
These are good questions. It sounds like these are very adult conversations that Trump supporters need to start having instead of these childish conversations that they keep having defending their cult leader, Donald Trump.
Right. Some of the stuff like the immigration thing, for instance, there was a tunnel set up in Mexico in a river. They took barbed wire, covered it up, and basically it was shoving people out, killing kids, to drown.
Wow, what a shame!
How is that Christian-like behavior? I'm not a Christian, so maybe someone can explain it to me, but how is that Christian-like behavior?
It's not Christian-like behavior, it's hypocrite behavior.
There you go.
And it preaches Jesus. I had somebody tell me today, I need Jesus. And this same devil is out here on TikTok worshiping Satan.
For real?
Yeah.
Oh, I've had
these folks are possessed. They come to me and tell me I need Jesus while they're literally on their way to hell with gasoline draws on.
And do you know what would probably fix it all?
What's that?
pay people a livable wage, everybody. You pay people what they're supposed to be paid. You pay people, and Trump supporters too. I'm talking to you guys, Trump supporters. How much happier would you be if your paycheck was lined right? Would you be worried about what other people, would you be worried about what LGBTQ was doing if your paycheck was right? No, because you'd be out vacationing. You'd be out enjoying your check.
I mean, even at this point, I don't care about what other people do as long as they're
exactly.
Because
you're a normal
themselves.
Person and you're not a Trump supporter.
Yeah. Right.
But the point is like people aren't making the right type of money that they should, and they should.
Well, they should get off TikTok.
Livable wage. Just
they
a
should
livable
get off TikTok and stop complaining.
That's what they say?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Pick yourself up by your bootstraps.
Well, I don't
impossible feat.
I don't know about that, but I know
the same people say
Trump
that.
Supporters, they need to stop sending Donald Trump their money, right? Because, you know, you ever hear them say things like, my 401k was doing great when Trump was in office. Well, yeah, because Trump didn't have you paying for his legal defense. But now now you're legal. Now he needs your money. You're going in your 401k. You're getting hit with these early penalties. You're getting taxed out of the wazoo. And then you turn around and wonder why your 401k has turned into a 101k.
What if you've not been taxed heavily for that? I mean, you've been penalized heavily for that.
Huh?
They act like that's not always been a thing. Your 401k has always been hit crazy if you take it too early.
Yeah.
And that's nuts. And not only that, that's something that is between you and your employer.
Yeah.
Basically,
that?
Like it's that contributing to, like that has nothing to do with the president.
Yeah. So for all of you who keep complaining about your 401k and the prices of eggs and, you know, the prices of gas, stop it.
Oh, the prices of food. See, that one gets me.
They spending all this extra money driving to these Trump rallies.
Mm-hmm.
I don't need any money for gas. Stop driving to his rallies.
Lost 250,000 since Biden, never been lower, and you have no idea about 401k. That's weird because I have one. So,
what did they say? What did they say?
I have no idea about my 401k.
Oh no!
Because I took
money out of
mine.
$250,000. Did someone say they lost $250,000?
Yes. Yes, I do have a 401k. In fact, I borrowed from it to pay off all my student loans.
Hey, mine is doing fine. Somebody said they lost $250,000 and they're blaming President Biden for that.
Eggs went down. Yeah, nice lady in here. So my husband thinks eggs are still $12. No, they dropped down to $1.99. I just bought some.
He's still repeating old talking points. He hasn't been updated yet. That's what it is. People are nuts.
What's up?
I say someone wrote people are nuts. All right.
You know, and the thing with the food, it's like, make them pay. Great grocery, and I'm just going to talk about grocery stores. Grocery stores throw away 10 billion pounds of food a year. Think about that. They just throw it away. They toss it. They could be repurposing to pig farms, horse farms. They could be jellying it, jamming it, freezing it, but they don't do that. They throw it away. They'd rather do that than take the money and cost because they get the kickback from the taxes.
You hear that? Yeah.
How about you just start penalizing them for that?
Yeah.
Give it away or like sell it at a reasonable price because there's no reason for this inflation at a market. There's no reason for anybody to go hungry in this country. It's insane. Not when you're throwing that shit away. Sorry. Not when you're throwing that stuff away.
I caught you again, Hazel.
I caught myself. Okay. Don't even start.
All right. Well, listen, I got to bring some of your friends up. All right.
My friends.
They're the guest requests, I should say. I don't know if you know them or not, but I got
probably not, or I don't want to.
Yeah, you know, if anyone that gets in the box and tells the truth, I consider them a friend.
Well, you're my friend, yes. All right, my dear. I'll talk to you later.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give the beautiful Hazel a round of applause. No lies detected. You hear this, MAGA? You see what we do over here? No one's getting in the box and yelling at each other. I could do what one of these other top content creators is doing because, you know, he loves to say he's winning, right? You know, yeehaw! He loves to say that he's winning, he loves to say Donald Trump isn't going to go to jail. And you know what he does when you go on his lives? He turns his camera around and he plays these disgusting videos of himself on TikTok lying about President Biden, lying about Hunter Biden, lying about Democrats, lying about I mean, I've never seen anyone win like this. You know what I call this? This is the last ditch effort to save face, because he knows, just like we all know, that Fani Willis, what has taken Donald Trump's lunch?
I am giving the defendants the opportunity to voluntarily surrender no later than noon on Friday, the 25th day of August, 2020. Every individual charged in the indictment is charged with one count of violating Georgia Racketeer Influence and Corrupt Organization Act. You can hide.
We gonna get him. We got him. We got him, Joe.
I am giving the defendants the opportunity to voluntarily surrender no later than noon on Friday, the 25th day of August, 2023.
You know, I love how she didn't leave any areas to wonder, right? Friday, well, what day? Oh, the 25th. Of what year? 2023. Yeah. She didn't miss any areas in terms of letting Donald Trump know, you better bring your behind. You better bring it by this time or I'm coming to get you. And I love how she says, I'm giving you every opportunity. Making it sound like he has a choice. Well, he does, right? I guess he does have a choice in at what time to get there, right? I think he said he's going to turn himself in on Wednesday. Did he say he's going to turn himself in Wednesday? Somebody, Trump supporters, can one of you call up President Biden's DOJ and ask when does Trump got to turn himself into Fani Willis, right? All right, let's bring up our next guest. All right, music is your soul. Greetings, how are you doing this afternoon?
Zeus, it's so good to see you again. I'll be very short.
It's nice to see you too.
I am a little on the outside looking in. I'll give you a little bit of Canadian perspective. What I want to say, and by the way, Hazel just nailed it. Man, she is a smart girl. And I've heard that whole syndrome used as, you know, basically for people that get caught into systems. Like, you know, when the United States was in Vietnam, you're there so long, you lost the whole idea about why you were there. You're just there because you all of a sudden it's just become, you put kind of put your brain in autopilot. But it's Ukraine. Just want to let you know, Canada is sending billions of dollars to Ukraine.
Wait a second. Canada is sending money to Ukraine?
Yes. UK is sent, the United Kingdom, Germany, Sweden, Poland, France. And you know what? For some reason, they're not laundering money over there. They're not laundering Canadian money over there. It only seems to be happening to American. So the thing is guys from MAGA, you got to get over this whole idea that Ukraine is laundering money.
You're right.
You got to get over the fact that, you know, you're sending money over to Ukraine. You're not just sending money to Ukraine. The rest of the free world wants Ukraine to experience the same freedom that you are experiencing right now in your country. The Canadians are experiencing in their country. France, right. Germany, Poland.
Right.
All of these countries are supporting Ukraine against a dictator. A dictator who is launching missiles into hospitals and schools and apartment buildings while the Ukraine army are trying to fend off Russian army. The Russian army is killing Ukrainian civilians. And for some reason, MAGA has embraced this mass murderer. This
Why do you think they embraced Vladimir Putin?
I can only think that it's love by association, because their dictator, their MAGA monster, Trump, loves Putin. Therefore, they have to love Putin. It's like you're a friend.
And they don't even see anything wrong with loving Putin. I've seen some Trump supporters with the Russian flag.
Yep, absolutely. And even at some of the Christian rallies that just boggle my mind, because
who raised these animals?
The thing is that the left doesn't have things like Turning Point or the conservative conventions that, and these are rallies. These are basically have turned into hate rallies, and they've just drive a truck right down the middle of the United States, and Democrats are the enemies. They're the traitors of the country. And it's like, no, you guys are all living under the same flag. You are American citizens. And believe it or not, I think if you sat down and got out from under the cloud, the negative cloud, the dark cloud of Trumpism, you'd actually find that you have a lot more in common with each other. Wow. To sit down. Like when I was a social worker, I used to go into court and we used to have what was called a statement of agreed facts. What do you agree on? Where do you want to go? Because I think here's the thing. The GBLTQ2A+ community is not going anywhere.
Right.
That's abortion is not going anywhere. There's going to be abortion. There's going to be Muslim people in your country. There's going to be immigrants coming into your country legally and illegally. They come into Canada legally and illegally as well. You're not the only country with an immigration problem. But if you
leave it to a lot of our conservative friends, they tend to give the impression that, you know, all those things you're suggesting, they complain about. They make it seem like that's really what's going on in this country. Yep. And only America, and it's only happening because of President Biden.
Yep. So from my perspective, what I'm seeing is that Biden is building for a bright, beautiful future.
Amen.
He says, everybody, no matter who you love, no matter where you come from, you can be a part of the American dream. You can live in the freedom, which is the hallmark of your country.
Amen.
And you can strive to live and prosper, and you can enjoy all of the great things. It's for everybody in the country, not just for a chosen few. Amen. But that's the thing that I think MAGA sees and doesn't really, they see it's a danger sign that you're going to erode the country, and we want to take it backwards. Biden says, no, there's prosperity here. The unemployment rate is down, stock market is flaring. The concerts are full.
Taylor Swift is doing lovely. You hear Taylor Swift? She's breaking records.
That's right. The sports stadiums are full every night. The restaurants are full every night. Disneyland is full. The country is strong. No matter how many MAGAs want to say that it's on fire and burning, it's only the United States has a bright, beautiful future. And I think that you're going to look back in 10 years at this point as a pivot point, pivot point in the history of the United States, where you're going to enter into a bright and wonderful new age.
I completely agree. Well, listen, music, thank you so much, my friend. All right.
Thanks for having me on there.
And thanks for always bringing that level of truth to this platform. We need more of it. All right.
Really appreciate you having me on.
Anytime, my man. Anytime. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give music a round of applause. No lies. No lies detected. That's how we keep this show booming on the map, right? Keep it booming on the map. You know, Ladies and gentlemen, it is now time for Zeus to depart. I'm so sorry. I got to go tend to other affairs in the kingdom, but I do hope you enjoyed this episode, this emergency episode of the Closet of Truth, all right? Because you know what we got to do. We got to keep holding these Trump supporters accountable for their crimes and their dirty, disgusting, filthy deeds. And reminding the American people of all of the wonderful work President Biden has accomplished in just his first term. If the choice is truly between President Biden and Donald Trump again, I think it's crystal clear, everyone, who you should vote for. You want to be on the right side of history, or do you want to be in jail, right? Because guess what, Trump supporters? Jail and hell will be your portion as long as you continue to let that MAGA-possessed demon infiltrate your body, heart, and soul. So, I'm going to ask once again before I get up out of here, is there any Trump supporters, any MAGA, want to get in the box and apologize today? You've heard a lot of truth. There's been a lot of truth in this live. You got one more chance to apologize before I end this live. Anyone want to apologize? David, you want to apologize. You're a Trump supporter and you want to apologize. Uh-oh, ladies and gentlemen, I think we have someone. David, you're a Trump supporter. Let's see. All right. Let's see if David is really being honest, because David, you might break the internet today. David, greetings. David, can you hear me?
Yeah, I want to apologize for everything Biden's doing. Yes, I can hear you.
Oh, wait a second, David. See, David, you got in the box and I had to stop you before you end up getting my live reported, because the first thing you did, you was lying. Now, David, just like that, the devil done slipped a link in you. I said, and my instructions were very clear. I said, David, any Trump supporter want to get in the box and apologize? David said yes. He said yes. I read yes. He gets in the box. He gets in the box and says, yes, Zeus, I want to apologize. Oh, you do? Yes. What do you want to apologize for? I want to apologize for everything President Biden has done. David, have you lost your mind? What a shame. What a shame. Dave, I think there's a comprehension problem. I said President Trump. You said yes. You get in here and you then apologize for President Biden. Dave, please help me understand. How did you get onto President Biden when we were talking about President Trump, Dave? Please. Can you answer that question for me? Because, you know, that's one heck of a trick. That's one heck of a trick. All right? And I don't want to say you were lying to Zeus in the kingdom, but I'm very curious, Dave, how on earth did we get on to President Biden in that was a split second. You didn't even have time. I didn't even say President Biden. It's the MAGA demon. It is truly a MAGA demon that has taken over Dave's mind. Dave, are you there? Dave? Somebody go get Dave, tell him to come on back. I wasn't done talking, but I can't have you in my box spreading lies. All right, Dave, great. How did you get on to President Biden? Were you trying to be funny, Dave? Is that what you were doing? You were just trying to be funny with Zeus? We're really concerned. Is it possible, Dave, for you to simply apologize? Dave's not here. Is it possible for you to apologize? I guess not, Dave. I guess not. So you're going to hold on to Donald Trump for dear life and risk your health, your freedom for Donald Trump? Well, I guess that's it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I got to get out of here, all right? Until next time, take care. Wait a second, Dave. Hold on. I am, because Joe Biden Congress has all the paperwork to prove. Dave, you didn't explain how you got on to Joe Biden. I was talking about Trump, Dave. Keep your mind focused on Donald Trump. Stop talking about Joe Biden. All right, I'm out of here. Sorry about that. Thank you. Take care, everyone.
Zeus, this is how I sound when I'm talking like Zeus. This is how I stare when I'm looking like Zeus. I like to act a fool when I'm moving like Zeus. Don't be playing with my mood when I'm moving like Zeus.
Thinking
that you're cool till I pull up like Zeus. Thunder in the sky,
Mr.
like
Mount
you
Negro,
look like Zeus.
Mount Negro,
I'm a god, call me Zeus. I'm flyer than the eagle, I got red on me too. Took a long time to get here and I'm feeling brand new. If you living like a bum, get away from me, fool. I got money in my mind, I can leave it up to you. This is where your butt feds when you playing with the gods and you playing with the dead. Hey, little mama, let me play with your caboose. I know the ladies love me because I'm sweet like a tooth. Playing hating on the gods, boy, he's such a douche. I tried to be patient, but you had it like my fuse. I'm catching all these snakes like a mongoose. I'm the one that they choose. You know I'm so handsome, that's why they call me Zeus. This is how I move when I'm walking like Zeus. This is how I sound when I'm talking like Zeus. This is how I stare when I'm looking like Zeus. I like to act a fool when I'm moving like Zeus. Don't be playing with my mood when I'm grooving like Zeus. You're kicking at your core until I pull up like Zeus. Thunder in the sky, like you up like Zeus. I'm a god, call me Zeus. I'm hotter than Hades and I'm burning down. You say you wanted facts, well, I'm living proof. I've been waiting for this moment, now I gotta choose. If you play around with love, then you guarantee to lose. I don't make the game of rules, so don't play me like a fool. If you can't swim, don't be in the pool. Even though I'm hot, people telling me be cool. I'm just sitting on my throne while you looking like a goof.
Hey,
grab your goose. Hey, little.
Oh my God. All right, ladies and gentlemen, what in the earth just happened right here? All right, I'm out of here. Take care.